Hello dear students, so we are going to start the topic moment of inertia. We have completed the topic centroid. Now this is actually a continuation of the topic centroid. Moment of inertia, it is actually a geometrical property of an area which reflects how its points are distributed with regard to an arbitrary axis. So as I told you, moment of inertia is a property which reflects how the points are distributed with regard to an arbitrary axis. To explain this, see, let us take a rectangle and this is the axis. So if the orientation is like this, with respect to this axis, or you think maybe the rectangle is like this or maybe like this. So in each case, this property, that is moment of inertia, is changing. We know the area is same, the axis is also same, but the orientation or the distribution of the area is different. That's why the property moment of inertia is also changing. And mathematically, we can write it as the sum of products of the area and the square of the distance. I shall explain it with a figure. You imagine an area like this, and you have an axis, x axis and y axis. Now let's consider a small area. Let it be dA, and the distance from x axis, that is represented by y, and the distance from y axis is represented by x. And this is dA or delta A. Now, as per the definition, this is the sum of products of area and the distance square. That means I, x, whenever you are writing moment of inertia, we have to write the axis also, reference axis. I'm going to write it with respect to x axis. So, I, x is equal to the sum. Sum means we are going to write sigma, sum of area. Area is delta A into, and the distance from y axis, that is y, sorry, distance from x axis, that is y square. Okay. And we have to give an index I, which is varying from, I is varying from 1 to n, where n is the number of parts which we are going to divide this area. So I x equal to the summation of area and the square of the distance to that area. Now if dA is very small, Ix, sometimes we write it as Ixx also, Ix is equal to, this will take the integral form, integral of, let me write the y first, y square into dA. So this is the equation for moment of inertia of the area A. The whole area is actually, this is actually total area is A, y square dA. The same way we can write moment of inertia of y with respect to y axis, iy or iyy, that will be integral of, so similar to y, the distance from y axis is x, so integral x square dA. This is iy